Well, howdy, 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 folks. Let me get this turned off or down. It should start here in a second. And I am happy to be here. It is Tuesday night, and I meant to do this yesterday. I didn't have time, and so I apologize. In the background, that is something I did this weekend. Those are my favorite hot dogs. I have to have them flown in, FedEx overnighted on dry ice. And they are so freaking good. Those are called pop opens. If you follow, I put it on the YouTube stories, but I love those hot dogs. They sell a red and white pop open. You can Google it. The company's name is Zweigels or Zweigels. It's ZW and two consonants like that. Messed my head up. And so this hillbilly can't pronounce it. And then if you notice right there, that's my wife's, her normal ballpark chicken pecker and beak dogs. So, yeah, double T, take two. I accidentally clicked the go live a minute ago. Had to reset because I hadn't done nothing yet. I just turned it on and I accidentally was moving a picture and I hit go live. So I apologize for that. I am glad y'all are here. I want to make sure, let me make sure that this is working. All right, I can see some chats. Look, there's Dan Katz from Jacksonville. I see that Jeff Mack is here. If you aren't following him, he's another one you should be following. Double T, Kurt Cash is here. I think he was actually here a little bit ago. Hold on just a second. Let me take a sip of my drink. I want to tell you about Craig Sinclair. He's pretty new in vending. He worked for Kirby Vacuum Cleaners for years, I think since Noah landed the Ark. And he's done well, but he started vending, and he's trying to get he's building his own commissary / restaurant, and he wanted to start vending. So he gets him a pop-up tent, some signs, and even some hand-done signs, and goes out and vends. Well, a week ago this past weekend, he kills it. And I'm like, dude, that was an amazing event. And he shared it with us in Vendors United. He's one of the members in the Vendors United, so he shared all his numbers and stuff. Well, then this week, he calls me up messages me on Friday and says, hey, I'm thinking about trying hot dogs this time. He doesn't have a cart there. It's no cart. It's just table and you know what the Bain Marie's are? It's like a steam table, you know? It's an electric steam table. And so you have your pans in it just like you would a cart, but it's sitting on top of your plastic fold-up table. Well, he messages me and goes, hey, I'm thinking about doing hot dogs this time and some other stuff. What do you think? And where can I get them? I need them right now. I mean, this is Friday evening, and he's got to be there Saturday morning. It's like a two-hour drive or an hour and a half drive to where this thing is. And I want to read you what he said. This stuff just inspires me. These kinds of stories and these kinds of people that are just go-getters. I ain't stopping for nothing. I'm going to do it. Kiss my butt. All the naysayers can keep on naying, you know. Nah. And so let me tell you what he does here. So he says, hey Ben, anyway, it's in the Bay Area of California. Now he's got his permit and everything. And so, but he's still not vending with a vehicle of any sort. He's tabletopping this, and it's what I teach to do. I put a link right here, learnhotdogs.com now, if you want to know how he did this, okay? And it's legal, and California is one of the worst states in the country, so if he can do it, you can do it, okay? So, anyway, he sends me these pictures, and I'm going to share the pictures with you, okay? And he gets there at 5 a.m. to set up. And there's other vendors. It's like a, what is this? It's called Tulare Swap Meet. Tulare is somewhere in California. Tulare. Swap Meet. So he's doing the swap meet. He gets there at 5 a.m. At 5:05, he says, my first tri-tip sold. Now, what he's doing is buying tri-tip. And this is what happened the previous weekend. He bought tri-tip and he couldn't keep up with the crowd. Okay? He couldn't cook it fast enough. He's cooking it there on grills. Okay? He's got like backyard grills set up. And so he was cooking it there. So he asked Inventors United. He goes, I need a better way to do this. What do y'all suggest? And they suggested, listen, par cook it and have it nearly ready. Throw it on the grill, finish it up, hold it in steam pans, or completely cook it and hold it in steam pans. And he's like, okay, I'm going to do that this time. So he goes out there with everything ready, and I'm going to read you exactly how he sent this to me. Let me see if I can get this picture up. Let's see. I think this is the first picture he sent me. Okay, I'm going to step out of the way just a little bit. And if you notice, it's... I don't know if you can see that. It says, I'm getting in my own way. Caitlin and Ashley's kitchen. That's his daughter. And so he's doing, it's inspired after that. So he's got a cool looking logo, banners. He's got a sign. Do you see that big sign? It just says tri-tip. Tri-tip, not a prize, just tri-tip. I freaking love it. So it tells him what's there and a picture of it. Here's what's here. Come over here. So he starts setting up at 5 in the morning. By 5:05, he goes, at 5:05, and it has been nonstop. He sold his first tri-tip at 5:05, been nonstop for my cook. Now this is at, he sends this to me at 9:22. So 12:22 my time, because we're 3 hours apart. So 9:22 in the morning, he sends this to me, and he goes, I've been nonstop. And we're already over $2,000. Here's some pictures. So he sent me these three pictures. So you see what he's doing there? You can see his whole setup there. It's fairly simple setup, right? He did his whole setup, he told us, for under $500. And he said before he got his fancier banner, he was under $300, and he added some other fancy banners. He was using the previous weekend, last weekend, the weekend before last, he was using, everything was homemade. So, homemade signs. Let me pull up this other picture, and you'll like this. Okay, oh, wrong picture. See? Where is my picture? I think this is it. Okay, here's another angle of that setup. He's got mosquito netting, which is required, or bug netting, whatever you want to call it. And do you see what he's got there with his just tables and these Bain Marie things? That they're like just a tabletop steam table. That's it. So he's holding stuff, and I'm gonna show you the foods too. Let me see if I can get this other image up. Hopefully this isn't the one I just... Yeah, see, I'm horrible at this. They're so tiny, I can't see them till I pull them up. And so anyway, I'll just go through these one by one and that'll solve it. So you saw this picture, and then I'm going to show you another picture here. I'm going to move out of the way. Okay, this is a picture of his hot dogs he went and got. And he's got those in a steam table, and you can see that. And then he goes... let me make sure I'm in the right picture. Okay, there is... I'm going to have to read this to you because I don't remember what that was. Maybe ribs. I'm going to tell you what he did, though. I'm going to give it... He said I could share this with y'all. Hopefully I haven't shared this one yet. Okay, that was the first one I shared. Okay, there's something else. Burgers. He pre-did those. I want you to look at this. Now, I would hold my burgers in an au jus. Just so you know, we have this on learnhotdogs.com. Hold them in an au jus. An au jus is just a beef juice or a beef broth. And it keeps them juicy and tender. And then you can throw them on the grill right at the last and get the wetness off of them. But most people don't even care. They love them. And the beef juice just keeps them from drying out. Oh, wrong picture. Okay, I showed you that one. And maybe I'm done. who knows? I can't. It's stupid. This thing, every time I select a picture, it scatters them. And then I have to go back. And it doesn't like let me hold them in a file, so I apologize for that. Anyway, that's some of the pictures. Let me see if I can find it on here. This may speed it up. Okay, here's another picture. This, I think, is the tri-tip. Yes. Boom. Tri-tip. That's what he has on that sign, y'all. He's got the tri-tip on the sign. He's doing this from a table. And I'm going to put that table back up so you can see what he's doing. This is Craig Sinclair out of California, if you're wondering who I'm talking about. This is his setup. So, Caitlin and Ashley's kitchen, he calls it. And so he drove all the way there, and he's slamming, right? Well, check this out. Just, now my time is, my time was 12:52. He sent those pictures, so his 9:52. Then he says, my goal today is 10 grand. Now, he told me this on Friday. Then he told me again at, this is at, like noon. His time, noon. And he goes, my goal's 10. I'm already at 2 at 9:22 in the morning. He was already over two grand earned, right? Just fantastic. Okay, so then here's the email. Holy crap, wrapping up the day here in Tulare. What a great day. Sold out of ribs. 100 pieces of three ribs each, 33 plates at $9 each for a total of $297. Then sold 96 plates at, I'm going to step out of the way so you can see that picture, 96 plates at $5. That's $480. Then he sold 110 hamburger plates at $6 each, which was $660. Then he, and he goes, my winner, again, is the tri-tip. I sold 751 plates at $9. My total, $6,390, plus my drinks, which was over $1,050, almost $9,000 in one day. Freaking excited. He was so excited, and I can't blame him. Now, I want to tell you something. I put the link right there. Okay? LearnHotDogs.com/now. In case you want to learn what he did, like how to do this, you can start now, instant vendor. You can become an instant vendor, even in California. So even in the strict states where Craig is, you get started. You do your P's, you know, cross your T's and dot your I's and all that mess, but you can get there. And there's all kinds of loopholes, and I teach you the loopholes. So I teach you that in some states, you can start doing certain foods without a permit at all, because it falls under the Cottage Industry Act in your state, or it falls under the agriculture exemption. And then all of a sudden you start vending and you start making good money and you go, oh my gosh, where's this been all my life? Because now I have freedom. And there's a beauty to that. There's a beauty, because do you think that Craig needs to work till next week if he doesn't want to, or even the following week? Of course not. He's now, well, I don't have permission to share what he made the previous week, but he worked 2 days in a row. He made a lot of money, but he's brand new. He's brand freaking new. And it's so cool. Like last night, every Monday night in Vendors United, we do a private VU group, you know, mastermind, we call it. And everybody helps everybody. We overcome obstacles. We talk about tips and tricks and cool things and ways to make more money and ways to work less and make more money, which is a good one. And so he came on and he's like, oh, I got to tell you what it did. Because nobody had seen the email that he had sent me. Nobody knew about it, right? And I got his permission to share it with you. So I didn't like sneak it in there. So it was cool. And then there's stuff like this. I want to just tell you, this kind of stuff is what I live, sleep, breathe every day. I love getting the good stuff like this. Now I get bad stuff too. I get, man, I'm really struggling here, Ben. What can I do? Well, send me the picture, send me this, send me that, and I'll figure it out. Because there's always a solution. Always a solution. If your house is blue and you don't like blue, there is a solution, right? So this isn't like, hey, I didn't win the lottery. What's the solution? No, that's luck. And we don't deal in luck in this business. We deal in facts. So if you do these steps, you win. Every time, everybody does who does these steps. Period. There's no maybe. There's no anything. It's a guarantee. So that's what brings me excitement. That's what makes me happy is I watch people that struggle in life, whether they're truck drivers. We've got a ton of ex-law enforcement who are used to making a salary or whatever, and all of a sudden start doing this and change their entire life. Entire life. It happened for me, and it happened for you, and it happens for thousands of other vendors. And what's cool is there's plenty of it to go around. I get the calls sometimes, Ben, man, you keep teaching this, there'll be too many. No, because not everybody has work ethic. Not everybody wants to be their own boss. Some people like to be told, John, I'm going to need you in at work tomorrow at 7 a.m. I'm going to let you have a pee break at 10, and then you get to go to lunch at noon. Some people like that method, okay? I have no problem with that, and I'm glad there's people out there like that because I like the fact that my roads are smooth because somebody's paving them, okay? My point is that the people that invest the time, do the due diligence, follow these steps, they will be successful, period. There is no maybe. There is no iffy crap with this. And I love that about this business. That tri-tip looks good. Dan says, it does, Dan. It's freaking awesome. And I'm sorry I've been ignoring the messages here, but I'll look at it here in a second. So let me read you this one, okay? This is another one I'm going to be sharing in an email to everybody because he sent me a bunch of pictures, but I want to just share you just a little bit, okay? And I'll skip some of this, okay? But I'm going to share it all in the email, but this says, I thought I'd just would check in with you and let you know our success. This guy's name's Tony, okay? And his wife's name's Colleen, and they have Lucky Dogs Hot Dog and Catering, okay? And they have Lucky Lemonade, too. They have a whole nother business, Lucky Lemonade. Listen, my husband, Tony, and I began with the hot dog business and purchased your Cater Pro. We have been doing very well with it. Our focus was working horse shows that our daughter competes in. And they keep going. Listen to this. We then added lemonade, and you know what? Y'all need to be in the lemonade too. I need to share this with you just so it's on the screen while I'm doing this, because otherwise it won't get done. Bear with me. I'm gonna put another thing up here. Maybe. LearnHotDogs.com lemon. Okay, I have so much, a free course and everything on lemon, okay, lemonade. So there's your two things you can go to today if you want. If you want to change your life, if you, even part-time, because what happens is you start part-time and then you go, oh my gosh, why am I making $500 a week or $1,000 a week when I could be doing double that, triple that, and work less? Because the name of the game isn't just to see who can get the richest doing it. It's who can have the most freedom. Because once you have enough freedom, I've got vendors literally that work 4 days a month. There's one in Georgia that does about 3 days a month. But the point is they don't work full time and they make a full time income though. So they've picked it out. They've narrowed it down. They've scoped it out. So that's all available to you. So if you're miserable or you have a friend who is miserable with their job, they don't have to quit their job and go out on a limb. No, start part-time. Take your next day off and do this. And I'll show you the right ways to do it so that you're successful every freaking time. Okay? Now, I want to finish this reading this real quick. We then added lemonade, and it makes at least 100, that's 00, a day. We charge $6 for a 32-ounce lemonade and $8 a cup for flavored lemonade. Now, what these vendors, if you've seen me with Ken Packer or with Alex with Frankenstein's, which is now changing his name to Primetime. It's cool as heck. That's a whole nother story. He told us all in Vendors United last night. But the bottom line is you make this lemonade, and then you smash in with your smasher fresh strawberries. And you're going, well, what about the out of season? No, it's still doable because strawberries come frozen in a bag. You let them suckers thaw a little bit and smash them up with your pneumatic smasher or your manual smasher right in front of the customer. They get fresh strawberry goo all up inside their lemonade, blueberries. There's all kinds of raspberries. There's so many. And so they're charging. I'm still talking about Colleen and Tony. They're charging another $2 just for that. So $8 for a 32-ounce cup. Now, I'm not going to go into all this tonight, but I am going to tell you this. A 32-ounce cup with ice, with your drink, leaves you about 14 ounces of drink. So you're literally making $8 for a 14-ounce drink. That's a little tiny bit bigger than a Coke can. Okay? So, let me finish. Our flavors are strawberry, mango, pineapple, and raspberry. If a customer wants to add more than one fruit flavor, then each additional fruit flavor is one more dollar. We use all fruit and no syrups. See, that is brilliant. Listen to this. A recent car show, we made $2,568 in 3 hours. 3 hours. So I've got more to this, and I'm going to share it in an email, but I wanted you to know. Maybe I'll do a live tomorrow with it because I've already been on here long enough. But there's so much you can do to change your life if you want to change it. If you want to change things, you're coming into fall right now. There is fall festivals. There's haunted houses coming up. There's pumpkin patches. There's corn mazes. I've got vendors that did $10,000, no joke, that are in our VU group at 2 corn mazes last year. They just show up, do the corn maze, and make a lot of money. So my point is if you are sick and tired of being sick and tired, there's options for you. And it may not be your cup of tea. And if you're not, you've probably already turned me off and went over to the Oprah reruns or Jerry Springer or whatever else. But the point is this isn't for everybody. It's not going to be overloaded ever, okay? There's people that come and go in this business. And then there's people that kick butt. The Jason Browns, the Corey Lawrences, you know, the O'Doggies, the Great American Hot Dog Stand. These people just keep going and they keep growing and making better, bigger. And guess what they gain the whole time? Like Boss Dogs, more freedom. They start turning down jobs. They have more freedom to spend with their wife or their husband or their kids or their grandkids, life in general. And after it's all said and done, what the hell else matters? What else matters in life other than that time you spend with friends and family? That's the value in life. So if $500 a month will get you there, then by all means you can do this in your sleep. If $5,000 a month will put you there, by all means, this will do it for you. If $10,000 a month is what you want, we got a vendor in a group. He's pissed if he doesn't make $15,000 every weekend. And he tells us, only did $13,000. You know, it just pisses me off. It started raining, people left, or whatever. He's always got something, and I'm going, oh my gosh, it's like the diamond earrings are scratching my iPhone problems. Them are first world problems right there. Only did $13,000 this weekend. Wouldn't you agree? That's a first world problem. So the bottom line is, there's a ton of value for you here. There's a ton of opportunity. If you want to change your life, you can. Okay? This may be a stepping stool for you to get to another point you want to be in. Okay? Maybe you want to pay for nursing school, and you've always wanted to be a nurse, but you can't afford it. So you go, hey, I know a lady right now who put both her kids through college with a stand she worked only on the weekends. So she was in front of a Tractor Supply. I filmed her several years ago. She put both her kids through college with her hot dog cart. So I'm telling you, you can do it. And you've got people in here right now in the chat watching this that can vouch for the fact you can do it. And you, I wish you well. I want you to do it. I've put some links all in that. I'm going backwards. All in that area. There's some links. And I'm representing today. You see my little hot dog? He's right here. Right there. Okay? So, I got a black shirt. I got a new black shirt with this hot dog on it, too. So, anyway, I'll try to come back tomorrow and share with you about Colleen and Tony. It's fantastic. I wish you well. I love you, and I hope y'all all kick butt. I want you to change your life if you want to. Some people, you don't need to change your life. You're good to go. I wasn't. I didn't like being on food stamps. I didn't like my kids going, why are we having to dye our tennis shoes blue with rich dye? I wanted to change those things. So, I did. And I've been fortunate enough to be able to help thousands of people do the same. And I've got thousands and thousands of testimonials, but I keep getting new testimonials, which makes it even better. I love this business. I love you. And I hope I can help you and see you send me a success story, because I'll be sharing it. I love you. Talk to you soon. Bye.